And we had another rumor on the Apple Beats saga. I feel like I should have some sort of like a jingle now at this point, an Apple Beats jingle, because it's been going on for now 5 weeks. The long debated acquisition of Beats Electronics and Beats Music is reportedly going to happen, according to the New York Post, and will be announced this week. Again, we don't know if that's going to happen or not, but I hope it won't be in the next 10 hours. Otherwise, the podcast is going to be out of date by the time it comes out. And so the New York Post states that the purchase price has been reduced by $200 million to $3 billion, which is still a very good price. It's likely that the reduction was linked, at least in my opinion, to a revaluation of Beats Music, since according to the reports that were leaked in the last few weeks, Beats Music has only got about 111,000 subscribers, in spite of the company's and AT&T's efforts to market it to a mainstream audience. So, that might have been the case. It might also be that Apple reduced the price out of spite for Dr. Dre's perhaps inappropriate videos stating that he was the first hip-hop billionaire in a fairly raunchy way, which is not really Apple style. So, Vicky, can I ask you what the sentiments were, aside from these rumors that, of course, we can't really substantiate in any way? What kind of sentiment you felt there was towards this acquisition, if any, at Music Matters? Have you heard people talk about it? And what is your take?
Yeah, people were definitely talking about it, and there was a lot of head scratching, quite frankly, and from people who were running some of the streaming services, some of the rights organizations, and I think there's general speculation of the headphones actually really make a lot of sense,
right?
Because they're the best-selling headphones. Apple already sells them. They have a an iconic look and brand, and you slap some Beats by Apple or that type of thing on it, and it really fits with the portfolio of what Apple has. The question of, well, couldn't Apple build high quality headphones if they wanted to? And I think the answer certainly is yes. But this jumpstarts them. I think it also puts them in the right, it puts them directly into the right demographic and
exactly.
In a younger urban market, and they don't have to build that brand. It can augment their own brand. But the interesting thing about Beats is that I've always maintained, from when I worked at Sonos, I got to learn a lot about the, channels and channel conflict, and, and Beats having both the headphones as well as now a music service, that kind of introduces a lot of channel conflict into places like Amazon and Apple, where they have competing services. I also believe that if Apple wanted to build an on-demand streaming service, they could certainly do that.
Right.
And so I don't think that any of this is probably like, one side of this acquisition is the killer reason. I think it's a mix of a lot of them.
Yeah, and it's been also said that that Apple may have wanted to acquire a third-party service so that it could keep the two separate for some time while it tries to understand how it can phase in streaming and phase out downloads.
Yeah. Well, it is fascinating, because when they launched their radio service, I think that one of the I think they intended it, or it certainly seemed like it from a product implementation, that they really wanted that to be very tightly integrated with purchasing.
Right.
But what really happened is there was somewhat of a cliff, and that when they started that, the people just stopped purchasing. And so then I would imagine they're probably looking at that and saying, okay, well, how can we better monetize this? Because, you can't monetize free very well. And Apple already has all of the consumers, that are using their devices in their ecosystem.
Yeah.
But I think the other important element to this is that there was a lot of discussion in Singapore was around Apple post Steve Jobs. And Steve was really a visionary, and he very much had his eyes is closely focused on brand and entertainment and culture, as he did into industrial design and shipping great products, whereas we don't necessarily see that with with Tim Cook. You know, he's a supply chain guy, and he's really, really much more of an analytical thinker. And so there was a lot of speculation when I was in Singapore about whether this was the, you know, also a big acqui-hire of getting Jimmy and Dre and artists and more of the creative side of it back into the Apple world. I could kind of argue that either way. But I think there's some merit to that, and I do remember at South by this year during the iTunes Festival there was an Interscope showcase, right, which I thought was really interesting, because that wasn't something that I would see as typical.
Yeah. Yeah, sure. And no, I mean, that's the interesting thing about this story. I think I could argue equally well a point for Apple buying Beats and a point against Apple buying Beats. So I think at this point, we're just going to have to wait and see how it shakes out. I mean, from my perspective, as somebody has worked for a service that was primarily focused on downloads for a long time, you know, how scary is it to the industry? We've talked about this a lot on the show in the last few weeks. How scary is it for the industry, the prospect of Apple shifting to a stream model from downloads?
Well, I think it is really scary, but they're also late to the game. Now, I think that, you know, the biggest advantage Apple would have is that they have, you know, by far the lion's share of consumer accounts in the world, where people have the ability to purchase on their phones and, you know, and very seamlessly integrate into their phones. But I think that the, you know, the ability to get a streaming service to have a lot of traction, the ability to build a great feature set and really get a sticky user experience, it's hard. It's very, very hard to do. And we've seen so many companies try that and fail. Yeah. So I think, you know, Beats Music is just barely out of the oven. And I actually think 111,000 subscribers, that's really not bad for the length of time that they've been live in the marketplace. But I think that the world is looking at streaming as the future for the global music industry, and, you know, having Apple jump into it, I think is probably something that solidifies for everyone that there is going to be streaming and subscription as in the marketplace for the foreseeable future.
Yeah, absolutely. And last week.